All right, hello everyone. I wanted to show a little bit of my small Pottstown Firebirds collection that I have. I promised you guys that I will do a little video, so here it is. As you see, these is the original with many team repairs, as you see by the stitches. Oftentimes back then, when after a game, if there was a loose thread, if there was a hole in a jersey, they'll just repatch it. By you, as you see, try to match the same color of thread and then put it over. So the more holes these jerseys will have, the more repair marks you'll have. As you see, there is one on the shoulders, there is one by the front number 50, and so on. So on the original Firebird jerseys before they switched to the Eagles, old uniforms were, as you see, in 1968, very beginning of 69, because afterwards it was just Eagles uniforms. As you see, it was the original Philadelphia Bulldogs from the CFL. They won a championship, and then the Firebirds were able to acquire all their uniforms for their chip, and therefore they reutilized them. As you see, it was made by the brand Sennick, which was the most popular brand of manufacturing football jerseys. This jersey, as you see, I was able to get it from Ottawa. He was able to sign it in there. You see number 50 on the front. Funny story enough, he actually was wearing it in the last decades as going out to camping and things of that nature. As you see, long sleeves there, longer than normal, with the stitching, the elastic band at the very end. Most of the jerseys show, always football jerseys show a lot of use around the shoulder pads. This is the front of the jersey. And then to show the back of it, as you see, with also the number on the back. Some of the other items I have, these I have to actually try to see if it works. A lot of millimeters videos. I actually acquired a projector, so I'm gonna try to see if I can make it fit and work. But these are very rare from ground level, as you see, 1969 championship game between Hartford Knights and the Pottstown Firebirds were led to the first title, 20-0 for the Firebirds. As you see, self-explanatory, it's written on them what they mean, where they came from. I was able to acquire it via auction house, not cheap at all, about $600-700 into these, and I have the risk of them being completely mildew or stuck to it and therefore not working, but I have yet to check them out. But they came from Hartford Knights medical staff. They later on, he became in the medical staff of the Norfolk Neptunes, and he was able to keep for all the years. He kept these, and then later on he passed away, and his stuff was up for auction. All right, so there's it with that. Then I got some more items. I got from Miss De Palma, Bill Stead's sister, as I just uploaded on the website again, the old Firebirds website. This is the flash drive that has all that information, so that's forever for reference and to take care of it. Also, many of the photos, I wanted to say thank you to Mr. Steve Cavallo. He was able to actually trust me with the original photos, unique photos of his father when he was the team president of the Firebirds. As you see, that's a family photo. These were copies of the originals. He was able to trust me and send me the originals, and then I was able to copy and send it back to him. As you saw, he put notes that his dad talking to King Corcoran's wife and Ron Waller's wife. As you see, right up in there. All right, and then is that, I believe, Mike Hunter in the photo. I believe, might be completely incorrect. Again, it's stuff when I didn't leave with these individuals leave, then I just referred to a lot of photos. Is that in Brian Bugney's offensive lineman? As you see, getting a cast in his arm. Rough guys, original shirt. All right, It's his mother, Steve Cavallo's mother, and his father, all before a game. At the high school, as you see, the high school stands. Bill Scott, the trainer for the Firebirds, great original photo, and many more. All right, after that, we got some photos. King Corcoran did an exhibition for Helmut Hunt in NFL Films. That's some original photos from that. This is a project of a replica of the Firebirds helmet, which is the same as the Eagles, with the silver wings. All right, that goes to some stuff that Bill Stats sent me, parts of scrapbook, beautiful stuff. This is where they were living when they moved on to the Norfolk Neptunes in 1970-71. Great stuff. We got then moving on to some programs. We got the program Hartford Knights versus the Pottstown Firebirds, opening of the 1969 season. And as I see, I always keep them in the sleeve or preserve them. I got a VHS tape, very, very lovely thing. Original aired when he first aired the documentary in the national TV. He has a little bit extra than the DVD actually have, but Miss Linda Robbie was able to give me these. Thank you very much for her. Excuse me on the background, my kids are always up to something, usually something no good. All right, then we got another. This is our original Firebirds shirt that you saw in one of the photos. Brian Bubnies was actually wearing it. This is from Arso Art Aloha. This was great material, soft material, in pristine condition, with the original logo right in there. All right, then I have a folder, Pottstown Firebirds, Wesley Kit, has a lot of the names. Then we got the Banquet program, very rare thing, 1970, Banquet program, beautiful stuff. Then we got over here to some stuff that I actually paid quite a bit of money. What a bit of money, we're talking about in the thousands, okay? These are originals from Mr. Alan Saylor, which was responsible for the marching band of the Eagles, and also for other stuff, such as coming up with some of the logos of the Firebirds. And look at these, this is extremely rare, original Pottstown Firebirds, professional expenses. Look at that. Self-explanatory, payroll to players, $43,000 at a time, make your math. Beautiful stuff. Did you see? More. Proposition, proposed income, how much charge, season tickets, all that. Great stuff. Right? Got more original stuff. Game one, the program of it, marching band. Beautiful stuff. Then we got an original letter. Look at that, very beginning of the Firebirds, still in red, the logo, July 68, before even a game was played. Arlen Saylor, Firebirds, requesting people's appearance. Another letter of the Bomb Squad, requesting more presence of people. Then, as we see now in December, he already changed for the default Eagles green, and now affiliate of the Philadelphia Eagles underneath. Two all season ticket letters. Dave DeFilippo original sign. Then we got the Department of the Navy. Recruitment of the drum to perform during off time. We got another one. This one, what's great is that it's in the Eagles letterhead. If you really look into it, it's in letterhead of it. Arlen Saylor, Saylor using Eagles paper to print Firebirds items. And there you go. These are some early sketches to how the Firebirds got to have the Eagle, the logo that they have, okay? Mr. Arlen Saylor was a pioneer of it. More stuff. See, you can press pause on this video, you can try to read it. Many unique stuff. Look at this. Some of the flags you guys see appear here and there with the marching band logos. Look at that beautiful equipment and all the ladies that were recruited in a grocery store most of the times, and some of their minors, as I mentioned in the book. School district, the contract with the school to rent the stadium. There you go. Assistant coach Stephen Burrow, contract of $2,000 per year, starting in 68, payable $62.50 per week, not to exceed the $2,000. Dave DeFilippo, $4,200 per year, $141 per week. Great. All right. We got many, many more unique stuff. Like I said, this was not cheap, but it's unique, and therefore I saved enough for it. Practice facilities again. This is all things got to be DeFilippo. There you go. Talking about how much you'll get paid. The Atlantic Coats directory. Look at that. Numbers and everything. Of course, they don't work anymore. And again, rental. How much will be off the stadium? Summer practice roster. 1968, as we talked in the book, there's many, many players. Some of them didn't even play. Paul Sersel, I have his helmet. Will match the jersey, the red helmet. I have it, but it's downstairs. So. But he referred to the photos. The Reading Buccaneers. Here, John, more letters trying to publicize as much as possible the Firebirds' existence, okay? Got some tickets, ticket stubs. All right. So as we talked about, hunt auction, $600 for the helmet. Another program. Some stuff from the original website. Another copy program. Print outs, another program. Try to go back to the box. I got original Unforgettables soft cover. This is the DVD you can find on Amazon, where you find the documentary, the part 1 and 2, that is also on the website. Art cover, first edition of the Unforgettables by Jay Egton. Soft cover of the Unforgettables, 3 editions. The same book. Then I got another program. Cut off. Fabio Stet, he had this with him. Another program. That's some highlights, some game highlights. Beautiful, rare stuff. Another program. Eagle's Nest, Bird's Nest, little magazine. We got Artwell, playbook. We got newspapers. We got another program. And we got paper plates and more programs. The Firebirds. What is original art for a program against the Firebirds, and some pencils, and that's more or less my collection. Hope you guys enjoyed it.